Gujarat invests in India is home to more than 20,000 Sindhis, an ethnic group of African descent. Though far removed from their ancestors' homeland, the Sindhis have cherished their culture. Now it's a source of income for them.
कई होटल होता है पहले हमने 1500 से स्टार्ट किया तो इसमें से रोज का दो तीन सीजन होता है तो छः छः प्रोग्राम रहता है तो उसमें वन आवर का खेल रहता है.
Imran is a Sindhi, a descendant of the Bantu people from Southeast Africa. He believes his ancestors originally came from Uganda. Now he lives in a small village called Jambur with his mother and grandmother. The village is surrounded by the forests of Gir, the last bastion of the world's 500 remaining Asiatic lions. Centuries ago, Africans from Ethiopia, Eritrea, and Somalia sailed to the Indian subcontinent as merchants, while others were brought as slaves. The Sindhis say they were elite slaves, serving the ruling class only. They appealed to India's Nawabs or Muslim rulers and the Mughals, a Muslim imperial power in the early 16th century, because of their loyalty and military skills. The United Nations recently launched an exhibit to raise awareness of the Sindhis' rise to positions of power through their military status. They created princely Sindhi states and served as kings themselves, a fact little known around the world.
Look at what they've accomplished for themselves and for Indian society. They rose to be noblemen, they rose to be commanders, soldiers, admirals.
The Sindhi today are the descendants of the 1800 people, as well as some Africans who arrived actually later.
In the 19th century, Africans from further south were brought to India. Among them were Imran's ancestors.
और जो जूनागढ़ का जो नवाब था वो लाया हुआ था किसी को बॉडी करके ले लाया था कोई कोई ऐसा कोई जिसे पटरी है ट्रेन का पटरी तो उनको उठाने के लिए कोई इंडियन का कोई काम नहीं है कि उठा सके तो हमारे लोग जो जैसे मजबूत होते हैं स्ट्रॉन्ग के लिए वो उठाना जरूरी है तो वो लोग भी इसमें भी आए थे कोई लोग बॉडी गार्ड के लिए आए थे इसलिए यहाँ पे लाए हुए हैं.
With the passage of time, some escaped slavery, establishing communities in forested areas. Today, life for thousands of Sindhis, such as Imran, is far from glamorous. Most live on the fringes of society in abject poverty. Fortunately, Imran is able to provide for himself through dance, and when he's not dancing, he works in the Gir forest as a guide.
कोई कॉलेज जाता है तो कोई जॉब मिल जाता है फॉरेस्ट में मिल जाता है आर्मी वगैरह में मिल जाते हैं तो थोड़े बहुत पैसे हो जाते हैं तो मकान अपने आप कर लेते हैं.
Besides their strength, the Sindhis say that the Nawabs also believed that they held a special relationship with the Asiatic lions and to nature itself.
जैसे हम लोगों को पता रहता है कि लायन कब डेंजर में होता है उसका हाव भाव कैसा है वो सब देखना पड़ता है कि जहाँ जहाँ हम लोग हैं वहाँ लायन है ही मगर उसको क्या है कि हम लोग परेशान नहीं करते कि हम लोगों का जो परिवार है उसको परेशान नहीं करते घर जैसा माहौल रहता है.
Imran is concerned about the surviving Asiatic lions who may become extinct if steps aren't taken to conserve them.
पहली बात तो है कि अगर यहाँ से लायन जाता है तो यहाँ के लोकल लोगों को तो तकलीफ पड़ेगी मगर ये लायन अगर उधर जाएगा तो उसको वो भी मर जाएगा.
When asked about their country of origin, the Sindhis said they consider themselves Indian.
फिर भी अपना देश हिंदुस्तान है तो इधर ही जीना और इधर ही मरना है.
This report was produced by Mary Ferreira for the United Nations.